Hello again, Fords. Welcome back to Wednesday's edition of H Vision. My name is Maya Cantorino, bringing you announcements and updates.
And I'm Matt Cleaver. There are many important announcements and events this week, with a lot of good features this episode. But with that, please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Today will be the HHS Activities Fair. If you've been looking for a club to join, now is the perfect time.
This Friday is a very big game for the football team, with their Fight for Life annual event. If you are attending, please wear a Fight for Life shirt, pink shirt, Haverford shirt, or an Alex's Lemonade shirt. Show support to those who battled or have battled.
Now, let's go on to the sports. Boys soccer had their senior night last night, facing off against Marple, defeating them 1-0. Girls field hockey played against Marple Newtown, winning 4-1. Goals were scored by Lauren Cascarina, Shannon Doherty, Riona O'Neill, and Erin Coyle.
Tonight at 5 p.m. will be girls volleyball Dig Pink against Springfield. If you're going to be to the big game, then make sure to wear a pink shirt.
Starting today is unified tennis, which goes from 2:30 to 3:30 p.m. and will meet in the cafeteria right after school every Monday and Wednesday.
And don't forget about the fitness center, which will be open lifting every Tuesday and Thursday. If there is another team using the facility, don't be afraid, as it's still open to all who wish to work out.
Before club announcements, let's check out the weather.
Hi, Fords. I'm Avery Tripler, and today I'm going to be covering for Hurricane Harrison. We have a high of 83 and a low of 58. It's a beautiful day out, so enjoy it while it lasts.
Now for club announcements. The National Business Honor Society meets to welcome their new members after school today in the amphitheater. Congratulations to all of the new members.
Rainbow Alliance will be meeting after school in the library every Wednesday this year. Students of all orientations and identities are welcome to attend.
Guitar Club will be meeting every Wednesday in room 126 and will last 2:30 to 3:30. See Mr. Allhouse for more info and details.
On Thursday, both the Chess Club and No Place for Hate will be meeting after school. No Place for Hate will be meeting right after school in room 224. All are welcome.
There are also a few fundraisers coming up soon, with FBLA starting their Gertrude Hawk chocolate bar sales very soon. They thank you for your support and participation.
Huda is having two fundraisers soon as well. This Friday to Sunday is their Teddy's plant sale. 10% off all purchases go towards Huda. On October 21st, they will have their car wash at Manoa Elementary from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m.
And wrapping up the announcements is today's college visits. Today will be Dickinson's College, Hobart William Smith College, Macalester College, and Penn State University main campus.
Now we can move on to the features. Starting it off will be a media review, where they will review an album called Revenge of the Dreamers.
In January 2019, Cole officially announced an album by posting an invitation to his social media and held sessions in Atlanta for others to come and participate in recording sessions. Revenge of the Dreamers 3 is what was created from this event, an album curated by countless artists and producers, all made in only 10 days. Ethan and I have listened to this album and the artists featured on it a number of times, so our opinion is far from unbiased. To compensate for this, we're going to find students from around Haverford and ask for their opinion on a few songs in the album.
Welcome to H Vision. Who am I here with?
Luke Sun.
Have you ever listened to J. Cole's music before?
Yeah.
What do you think of J. Cole's music?
I love it. He's my favorite. I love J. Cole.
What do you think about the song we played you?
Dude, that song was absolute gas. I loved it.
What did you like about the song, and if you could rate it out of 10, what would you rate it?
So, I can't pick a favorite part of the song, really. Just everything about it, it's just so amazing. If I were to rate the song out of 10, it would be an 11 out of 10. Am I right?
Yes.
And who am I here with today?
Joe.
Have you ever listened to Dreamville or J. Cole's music before?
I have. Big fan.
All right. What did you think of the song we just played you?
It was great. I like it. You know, just everybody on the track all gave it their best, you know, full throttle. Yes, sir.
What was your favorite part of the song? And if you could rate it out of 10, what would you give it?
11. I'll give it an 11. You know, J.I.D., you know, just love that man. Great, handsome man. Love him.
It sounds great. Thank you, man.
Thank you.
Hello, who am I here with?
I'm Cece Lanciano.
Have you ever listened to J. Cole and or Dreamville's music before?
I've listened to J. Cole, but not Dreamville.
What did you think of J. Cole's music?
I really liked it.
What did you think of the song? And if you could give it a rating out of 10, what would it be?
I would give it an 8 out of 10, and I really liked it.
Thank you.
Dreamville's Revenge of the Dreamers 3 shows a wide range of genres and shows off the talent of a variety of artists and producers.
After listening to the album in full, I would rate it a 7 out of 10.
I'd probably give it an 8 out of 10. I'd say my top three songs would be Down Bad, Wells Fargo, and Under the Sun.
My three favorite songs on the album were Still Dreaming, Revenge, and PTSD.
Wow, I might have to give that a listen myself. That sounded really good.
I totally agree. I might add some songs to my playlist. But now let's go on to see the Cheesesteak review.
Hi, I'm Matt Cleaver.
And I'm Tom Patterson.
And today we're reviewing Boccella's Cheesesteaks. Alright, so first we're going to start with a original normal cheesesteak. So let's take our first bite. See, I've had Boccella's a lot in the past, and one of the things I really love about their cheesesteaks is the creamy cheese on the inside. I really think it adds a lot to the flavor. I genuinely don't know what cheese it is, but it is probably one of my favorite cheeses.
Yeah. Yeah, I would say I really like the American cheese. I really like the American cheese because it's really good, and the way that the steak and the cheese go together is a great combination.
And the bread isn't... It's toasty, but it's not, like, crunchy. Overall, I'll be honest, I'd rate this a 10 out of 10. I absolutely love Boccella's cheesesteaks. I'll always get a Boccella's cheesesteak, no matter what.
Yeah, I would rate it also a 10 out of 10. I think it's very similar to an original Philly cheesesteak. And yeah, it's really good.
And now we're gonna try the chicken cheesesteak, which I will be honest, I've never had before.
Neither have I.
Already it looks very different from the normal cheesesteak that I'm used to.
The bread looks a little burnt, which honestly I feel like is sort of a good thing, right?
Because yeah. It's not my favorite part, but it doesn't ruin it.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna count that against it.
It creates more of a crunch.
The cheese does not mesh as well with the chicken.
I would agree. I think the cheese and the steak is definitely a better combination than the cheese and the chicken, just because the cheese and the steak
It's not bad, but I'm not exactly sure I'd want to order this as a regular at theirs.
So I would agree. I think, you know, where we're from, Havertown, just outside of Philly, right? We would think, you know, more of just a regular cheesesteak would be the better choice. Yeah, it's just a better combination.
Yeah, I rate this a 7 out of 10, which is a lot lower than the normal cheesesteak, but it's still good. It's just not my favorite.
I would agree.
And that was our Boccella's cheesesteak review. Overall, I really do think that the cheesesteaks there are incredible. They really have a lot of love poured into them. As it is a family-run business, I highly recommend anybody who hasn't already check out Boccella's.
I think most people like cheesesteaks. I think Boccella's is definitely a great place to stop in Havertown. It's got great, you know, menu items, not just cheesesteaks, but some other things as well.
Yes.
Yeah, everyone should just check it out and, you know, see how it is.
Thank you for watching.
Oh man, now I'm hungry.
Lunch is going to seem extra far away today.
Wrapping up the features is a sports feature on girls volleyball. Let's see how they played on this win last week.
Hi Fords, I'm Julia Davis here at the girls varsity volleyball game, and I'm going to show you a little bit about the team. Who am I here with?
Girls volleyball.
And what are your guys' favorite part about being on this team?
Seeing Sam.
Seeing Sam every day.
Seeing Sam.
Seeing Sam.
Seeing Sam.
I'm Sam.
I'm here with
Ava.
And what do you think makes a good team dynamic?
I think that a good team dynamic is just a group of people that is, like, everyone's there for each other, even when you're winning or losing, having a bad game or a really good game, just, like, everyone's there for each other no matter what.
I love that answer. I'm here with
Bianca.
What made you want to play volleyball?
My dad was a professional volleyball player, and he, same with my brother, he's playing in college right now, D1. So that inspired me to play volleyball.
Wow.
Wow, that was super cool.
That whole rally at the end was so clean, especially that hit at the end.
Well, that wraps up today's segment of H-Vision. I'm Matt.
And I'm Maya.
And I'll see you in another episode, Fords.